Hello, 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 and welcome once again to Movies That Pop. I'm the Colonel. Let's see what popped up in theaters this week. Friends, 2 weeks ago, in my review of Batman vs. Superman, I called that film barely a movie. Well, it appears I spoke too soon. 2 weeks too soon, to be precise, because here we have something being released into theaters that is truly pushing the limits of what qualifies as a narrative motion picture. Shot entirely from the perspective of one character, Hardcore Henry is a frustrating endurance battle with a couple of cool ideas which get milked, mined, and beaten to death with blunt force and repetition until they are no longer cool. Hardcore Henry has one intriguing gimmick, the first-person perspective. But everything gained from the fresh storytelling approach is quickly negated by the basic storytelling elements that this approach robs you of. Things like, the ability to track characters during action scenes, or editing for dramatic effect, scene transitions, and a compelling, multifaceted story. Like I said, there are a few things, including Charlton Copley's manic performance and the nifty trick of some of the how-did-they-do-that camera angles that cause flickers of interest from time to time. But every interesting element in this film wears out its welcome quickly, with overuse becoming so redundant that by the time the film rockets to its hyper-violent conclusion, you may be shocked at just how boring the copious blood and wanton violence have become. That's it for the capsule review. Let's get in depth. Now let's get this out of the way. The first-person shooter approach is innovative. It's risky, but it's fun. It provides ways to surprise the audience with innovation because we know all about cameras, how they're used, how much space they take up, and we like seeing things from a new perspective, looking for the hidden cuts, edits, special effects, etc. And you know what? Because I love you guys, I'm gonna let you see this type of filmmaking in the best form available, short form, just to satisfy your curiosity. In the description section of this very video, you can see the music video directed by Ilya Naishuler that got him the directing gig for Hardcore Henry. It's for a song whose title I'm not really allowed to say in this video, because it's dirty, by a group called Biting Elbows. Keep in mind, it's not safe for viewing at work or around children, but watch it. It's free, and it lasts about 5 minutes. And 5 minutes is, as it turns out, just about how long it takes for the novelty of this approach to wear off. The Brothers Grimsby had an opening scene that was shot from this perspective, and it lasted no longer than 5 minutes, and they cut away to other things in the middle of the action. In a feature film format, even at a relatively short 93 minutes, staying in the first-person perspective for the entire time, the experience is like waiting your turn to play a video game right behind someone who is really, really good at it. You just sort of sit there, passively watching him play through every level, shooting and stabbing, and beating the game in about an hour and a half. Now, does that sound fun? Would you pay actual hard-earned money for that experience? Here's the setup. Henry, the protagonist of the movie, wakes up in a lab being fitted with robot parts. His voice chip is about to be installed by his hot scientist wife when a bunch of mercenaries burst in, led by a villain who can be best described as sort of a Scandinavian Ewan McGregor who took too much ecstasy. Oh, and that villain, He has the power of telekinesis, which is never fully explained. It's the only character in the movie that has a supernatural power. Henry escapes, but the bad guys grab his wife. Oh, and that voice chip never got installed in his throat, so Henry never talks.
I'm here to help you. Is your speech module installed? But at least we know you're not deaf.
And you also never see his face. So right there, this movie has a protagonist that does not have a personality. Oh sure, he shakes his head yes or no a couple times, but other than that, he doesn't communicate with anyone the entire movie. And this again, is the protagonist. You can have a protagonist of a movie that never speaks, but can make you laugh or relate to them or root for them. But when your movie's hero is just basically an empty shell with no facial expressions, no dialogue, well, then your movie has a fundamental problem. The great character actor Charlton Copley plays, well, he plays a variety of roles, sorta. But the primary role he plays in the story would be in a video game like The Virtual Assistant or The Help Key. Our hero completes a new level, and then Copley's character just shows up or calls him on the phone and guides him to the next level. Copley is always fun to watch, and it's easy to say that he steals each scene here, but that would sort of beg the question, steals it from whom? He's the only one on screen! Hardcore Henry is manic, muddled, and confusing. Occasionally, the nauseating shaky cam action stops so that someone can explain something to you, and I do mean that literally. A character will often look directly into the camera and explain something right to you, or yell it at you over the sound of gunfire. I mean, yell it at Henry. Because basically, you become Henry, which is sort of normal when you're playing a video game, but since your local Cineplex doesn't have controllers attached to the armrest, you aren't really controlling anything. You're just passively watching through the eyes of a character with no memory, no voice, no dialogue, no facial expressions, no personality. He makes no real choices and doesn't change or grow like most main characters. He takes in information, follows directions, and kicks ass. Just like every other video game character. And by the time this inscrutable cipher of a main character has shot, sliced, decapitated, mutilated, and ripped to shreds the several hundredth anonymous henchman, by the time he inexplicably overcomes the telekinetic power of the guy who could just throw him across the room with a single thought, by the time your faceless protagonist beats the game, all of the things that were novel about Hardcore Henry, the first-person perspective, Copley's performance, and whatever intrigue or mystery was created with the scant plot will have been lost in the desensitizing onslaught of chaotic, joyless mayhem. I mean, seriously, this thing ends with a nihilistic orgy of violence that is the furthest thing from fun. It's relentless, numbing, grotesque. I mean, I'll give it this, it's certainly audacious. You know what else is audacious?
And I said, we need to build a wall.
Audacious doesn't necessarily mean good, people. Empty bag of popcorn for this tasteless mess. As an experiment or an exercise or a film school project, there may have been some worth to this. Check out that music video in the description and you'll see what I mean. But as a full-length feature film, which doesn't even satisfy the basic requirement of a relatable protagonist, Hardcore Henry is just an empty gimmick. A roller coaster without wheels. That does it for this edition of Movies That Pop. Don't forget to follow me, the Colonel, on Twitter, at Movies That Pop, and click the icon right down there to visit our channel. You'll be able to view all of our other videos, and more importantly, click subscribe so we can keep doing what we do. In the meantime, leave your comments below and click the thumbs up if you like what you heard. Thanks for watching. I'm the Colonel, and I am Hardcore, man.